Behind me is one of Carlos Nadal's salon series, where he paid homage to the painters that he knew and admired. This particular one is homage to Soutine. And the very interesting thing about this work is that within the painting is this beautiful galloping steed, which had been sculpted by his wife, the sculptor Floor Joris Nadal. I'm absolutely delighted to see this beautiful still life painting again. Its title is Nature More, and there's a very interesting story about this picture. When Carlos Nadal married his Belgian-born sculptor wife, Floor Joris, in 1948, they moved to Brussels, and they were invited back to Paris for a reunion. And they were walking down a certain street, and Madame Nadal spotted in a shop the most beautiful silk dress. And Carlos, to her amazement, was very enthusiastic about the dress. It was silk, blue silk, with beautiful ostrich feather emblems, orange and green, vibrant. And he said, "Florette, you must go and see if the dress fits." So she went in, and sure enough, she came out feeling very guilty with the said dress in a box. Anyhow, when they got back to the studio, Carlos said, "I must use that dress in a still life painting." And she said, "But Carlos, you'll get paint on it." "Oh, no, 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 I won't get paint on it." And of course, when he'd finished the painting, Florette went to retrieve the dress to find it covered in paint. It's a very sad story for Florette Nadal, but I have. In 1996, the Bruton Street Gallery staged one of Nadal's last exhibitions, and London critic and writer Laura Gascoigne wrote a very interesting article in this magazine called The Artist and Illustrator Magazine, and called him Carlos Nadal, the last of the Fauves. Within this article, she states, "Nadal's debt to Matisse and Dufy is obvious, but his vision is unquestionably his own. He's been called the Spanish Dufy, but when you compare Nadal's seascapes with Dufy, you'll find they are much, much stronger."
Well, definitely, and this was the image that we chose for the poster and for the invitation, because yes, I did feel that this particular picture really encapsulated what Nadal was about, as you said,
yes,
vacation, holiday, and travel. He was interested in the great sights, in Moscow and New York, all sorts of places, even our very own Harrogate. But
yes,
it was also the country lanes, the villages, and indeed the ordinary beach scenes where ordinary people were
exactly
enjoying themselves, that's truly Nadal.
I mean, it was quite typical for Nadal, Madame Nadal, to be going somewhere, even shopping, and Madame Nadal would say, all of a sudden, he'd put on the brakes, get out of the car, say absolutely nothing, get out his equipment, start painting, and usually she'd take a picnic, knowing that he'd probably be there for 3 hours. But that was, you know, her dedication. I mean, she dedicated her life to him.
I have the great honor tonight to introduce Dame Fanny Waterman, who was a great friend of Audrey Burton's, of course, Audrey and Stanley, whose names now grace the gallery. And I believe that Dame Fanny has some words to say tonight.
John and Layla. John, I think we owe you a great gratitude for your generosity in doing all you've done for this artist, who perhaps was unknown, almost unknown, when you first met him. And Leila, that was so interesting. I admired your passion and your enthusiasm. Speaking for Prens, the University of Leeds Arts and Music, and the Mercer Gallery in Harrogate, and you must be very proud of this event. Audrey and Stanley were lifelong friends of my late husband, Jeffrey de Keyser, and myself. And I know personally how they fostered young, unrecognized artists, musicians, ballet dancers, and supported worldwide charities and so many other wonderful enterprises all their lives. They believed in people when they needed help. And tonight, I think, would have been a dream for Audrey to be here with you, John, who I've known for many years, because I know Audrey was very fond of you. I'd like to say a few more words about the Burtons. There are three generations that I know of, and it's a legendary family, all renowned for their superlative generosity to all endeavours, not just the arts. In the second generation, there are the three sons of Sir Montague, Stanley, Raymond, and Arnold. And in the third generation, there's Jeremy, Austin, Jane, and all their families. So I just like to say that Leeds and internationalism owe a lot to the Burton family, and it's remarkable, such generosity. John, Leila, I mentioned Julian Rushton, friends of the University of Art and Music. I'm proud to be your vice president, and I wish to say I'd like to open this exhibition officially. Thank you very much for inviting me. I was delighted to be asked and honoured to accept.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Although we held one-man exhibitions for Nadal, after a short time, his popularity demanded work permanently on show within our gallery space. Hence the reason so many paintings being in UK collections. In 1986, the London art historian and critic Brian Saul, Philip Solomon, and I flew out to Barcelona in order to visit Nadal's studio to select paintings for the Solomon Gallery's Dover Street exhibition in 1987. Brian Saul found it hard to believe that this was going to be Nadal's first London one-man show, although he had exhibited at the Royal Academy in the 1950s. Having been involved now with the painter 33 years, I never tire of his works. During the early days, I was given great support from many people. To name a few, Francis Farmer, Peter Cochran, Brian Saul, and Philip Solomon. More recently, Anton Bulton, the Bruton Street Gallery, the Sala Perez Barcelona, the Harrogate Mercer Art Gallery, Dr. Hilary Darper, who was the inspiration for the Leeds University exhibition, and not forgetting, of course, Leila Bloom, who curated the Nadal 2011, the Stanley and Audrey Burton Gallery, the University of